number of children, I am your Chandramati ma'am. Each to having to meet lovely students through online class. Today we will start our social science 6th standard. Okay. As you all know already, there are three parts in our social science. First one is history part, second one is civics part, and third one is geography part. Now children, we will discuss about the contents of our syllabus. Okay, history part in first lesson, introduction to history. Second lesson, our Karnataka. Third lesson, prehistoric society. Fourth one, ancient civilization. Fifth one, the culture of Vedic period. Sixth one, Christianity and Islam. Seventh one, rise of new religions. And seventh one, important dynasties of North India. And second part, civics part. Civics part in first lesson, citizenship. Second lesson, national symbols and national integration. And third part, geography part. Geography part in first lesson, globe and maps. Second lesson, Asia, land of contrast. These are all contents of our syllabus. Today we are going to study about history part in first lesson, introduction to history. Okay. First, we will discuss about introduction about the lesson. Listen children, introduction is the most important part each lesson. So you should concentrate on the introduction. In this lesson has been divided into four points. First one, meaning of history. Second point, uses of history. And fourth point, the contribution by the Europeans to the construction of Indian history. To the construction of Indian history. Listen children, once again, introduction to history. In introduction, this lesson has been divided into four points. First one, meaning of history. Second one, uses of history. Third one, sources of history. And fourth one, the contributions by the Europeans to the construction of Indian history. Now we will learn about first point, meaning of history. See children, you should learn first point, what is the meaning of history. the meaning of history. The systematic presentation of past events is called history. What? The systematic presentation of past events is called as history. Okay, are you understand? What is the meaning of history or meaning of history? History means the systematic presentation of past events is called as history. It introduces uses the journey of human beings. And third point about the meaning of history, it tells failures and success of human of that journey. Okay children, the systematic presentation of past events is called as history. It introduces the journey of human beings. And third point, it tells failures and successes of human beings of that journey. While explaining the historical incidents, accuracy of place, accuracy of time and person are maintained in the history. These should be clear in the history, that is called history. Without these clarities, it became a story. Okay, are you understand? While explaining accuracy of time, accuracy of place, accuracy of person and time, these are all should be clear in that maintained the history. Without these clarities, it becomes a story. In your textbook, give two examples in sentence. Okay, now you will study about the two sentences. First sentence was, once upon a time, there was a king. He fought. He fought a war. This is the first sentence. Second sentence, Ashoka. Ashoka, who ruled? Pataliputra. Pataliputra in 261 BCE, before common era. He fought a Kalinga war. See children, here I wrote two sentences. Please all of you observe in two sentences correctly. First sentence, once upon a time there was a king, he fought a war. Second sentence is, Ashoka who ruled Pataliputra in 261 BCE, he fought a Kalinga war. Already I told what is the meaning of history. History means while explaining the incidents, accuracy of place, person, it is maintained in the history. In first sentence observe, here there is no accuracy of time and there is no the particular king name. Here there is no the particular war. So without these clarities, it becomes a simple story. It becomes a what? Simple.